Never say this is the end of the road. Wherever a drop of our blood fell, there our courage will grow anew. This song, written in blood, was sung by a people fighting for life and freedom. Our triumph will come and our resounding footsteps will proclaim, we are here.
Грозовые облака по натерикам на кручах залегли, кличут трубы молодого казака, пыль седая стала облаком дали.
Jewish partisans were armed resistance fighters behind enemy lines, guerrilla fighters, during World War II. And they were significantly fewer in number than invading German forces. They mostly escaped from ghettos or camps to join existing armed resistance groups, but some formed their own units. They got supplies from wherever they could, often stealing weapons and material from the Germans. Partisans also took what they needed from civilians when it was not freely given to them.
Partisans relied on hit-and-run tactics rather than conventional tactics, as their small numbers of weapons were no match for the Germans. They sought to destroy strategic military targets and their operatives, not civilians. Approximately 20 to 30,000 Jewish partisans spread across at least 10 Nazi-occupied territories in Europe, fighting the Germans. Jewish partisans fought in Greece, Italy, and France in the southern part of Europe, to Poland, Lithuania, Russia, and other regions of the Soviet Union further north.
The newsreel. It's how most Americans saw World War II unfold. American audiences watched the Nazis occupy major Eastern European cities in their advance toward Moscow and Stalingrad. Typical images of Jews during this time period depicted them as helpless victims of genocide. Yet from Soviet newsreels, we can see a rare glimpse of another side of the Jewish experience during World War II, as partisans. Jewish resistance fighters behind enemy lines who were determined on derailing the German war effort. This rare footage documents Polish and Russian partisans, which included thousands of Jews who escaped the virtual death sentence of Nazi occupation. To fight the Nazis, partisans endured extreme conditions, harsh winters, and little food, and being without permanent shelter for years on end.
Zog Nit Keynmol, as du gehst dem letzten Weg. Himmeln bleiene verstellen blaue Tag. Kommen wird doch unser ausgebänkte Schor. Sveta poigt an unser Trott, mir sennen do. Komm man wird doch unser Eis gebänkte Schor. Zweta peugt an unser Trott, mir sennen do. Von grünem Palmenland bis Land von weißen Schnee. Wir kommen on mit unser Pein, mit unser Weh. Ohne wo gefallen's, es erspritzt von unser Blut. Sprotzen wird dort unser Gwure, unser Mut. Und wo gefallen's, es erspritzt von unser Blut. Sprotzen wird dort unser Gwure, unser Mut. Es wird die Morgensonne begilden uns dem Heid. Und der Nächten wird verschwinden mit dem Feind. Der Reib versammeln wird die Sonne und der Kajor. Wie a Parol soll gehen das Lied von Dor zu Dor. Nur Reib versammeln wird die Sonne und der Kajor. Wie a Parol soll gehen das Lied von Dor zu Dor. Das Lied geschrieben ist mit Blut und nicht mit Blei. Es ist nicht kein Lied von a Fegeläuf der Frei. Das hat a Volk zwischen Fallen die gewähnt. Das Lied gesungen mit na Gannes in die Hände. Das hat a Volk zwischen Fallen die gewähnt. Das Lied gesungen mit na Gannes in die Hände. Zog nit keynmol, als du gehst dem letzten Weg. Wenn Himmeln bleien, ne verstellen blaue Tag. Kommen wird doch unser Eis gebänkte Schor. Sveta peugt an unser Trat, mir sennen durch. Kommen wird doch unser Eis gebänkte Schor. Sveta peugt an unser Trat, mir sennen durch.
Don't you tell me that you take the final way. Even when blue skies overshadowed by the gray. Sure the hour that we're dreaming for will come. We'll arrive with steps a-pounding like a drum. Sure the hour that we're dreaming for will come. We'll arrive with steps a-pounding like a drum. Sag nicht einmal, dass du gehst den letzten Weg. Schon Himmel bleien, ich versteh de blaue Take. Kommen weg nach unser Eis gebänkte Schor. Seh da peugt an unser Trott, mir ist einen Dor. Kommen weg nach unser Eis gebänkte Schor. Wer da peugt an unser Trott, mir ist einen Dorn.
Sag nit keynmol, als du gehst im letzten Weg. Chod himmeln bleine, verstehn bloie Tell. Kommen wird nach unser Eis gebänkte Schor. Wer da peugt an unser Trott, mir ist einen Dorn. Kommen wird nach unser Eis gebänkte Schor. Sveta beugt an unser Trott, mir seinen da. Von grünem Palmenland bis weißen Land von Schnee. Wir kommen an mit unser Pein, mit unser Weh. Und wo gefallen ist, dieser Spritz von unser Blut. Sprotzen wird dort unser Gwure, unser Mut. Und wo gefallen ist dieser Spritz von unser Blut? Sprotzen wird dort unser Gwure, unser
Mut.
Hello from Belarus! We are sending you
you our greetings from secondary school number 8 of Novogrudek.
Our town is closely connected with the tragical events relating to the fate of the Jewish community, Jewish resistance and the activities of the partisans during the World War II. Tuvia Belsky was the leader of the Belsky Group, Jewish partisans who set up a camp for Jews in the Naliboki forest near Novogrudek. As leader of the Belsky partisans, Tuvia's aim was to save the lives of the Jews, and they saved the lives of more than 1,200 Jews. Our school primary organization of the Public Association Belarusian Republican Youth Union is named after Tuvia Belsky. There is a memorial exhibition devoted to him in our school museum.
So what have we learned today? In the ghettos of German-occupied Eastern Europe, cultural activity constituted a form of defiance. The partisan movement was also a rich site of songwriting.
Hello, my name is Ilana.
And my name is Sandor.
And we are living in the largest city of our country, Chisinau, which is the capital of Moldova.
We're studying in high school in Herzen-Ort Technological Lyceum.
And our mission for today is to tell you about partisans which were on our territory during the World War.
Zog nit keynmol gestem letzten weg. Kost him den Bleien verstellen neue Tag. Kommen wird noch unser Reus gebänkte Schor. Svet abheugt und unser Trott mir seinen Dor. Kommen wird noch unser Reus gebänkte Schor. Svet abheugt und unser Trott mir seinen Dor. You know what a partisan is?
Yeah.
Yes. A lot of people became partisans. Hirschka didn't become a partisan, but he came back to the ghetto. And one day he came to myself, my sister, and a fellow who was in charge of this tragedian, Meshka, and said, look, I wrote 2 poems. We couldn't just come to the room and read the poem. This has to be done very, very secretly. But Hirschka wrote another poem. Zog nit keynmol as du gehst im letzten Weg. What is... Beautiful. When Hirschka read it, he didn't have the music for it. And you speak Yiddish, he was silent. Zog nit keynmol, an order, as du gehst dem letzten Weg. Do you get it?
Yeah.
He wanted to inspire us, so we should fight against the German and we should never lose hope. Hope is a very important thing in life. We listen to the poem.
So how many of you were listening?
There were 4 of us. There was Hirschka, naturally. There was a fellow who was in charge of the tribunal, Meshke. There was my sister, Bella. I have a twin sister who lives in Australia, in Melbourne. And myself, 4 of us. Naturally, we liked the poem very much, and people eventually started to sing it as a hymn, you know. Everybody needed some kind of spiritual support, something what would help him to survive and fight. And this helped us. He left a legacy. He left something to remember him for. And what is it? The song which you come to sing here. And every time when I hear this song, I remember Hirsha Glik, and I get my tears in my eyes. A good friend of mine perished, but he was a hero. Why?
What's special about the partisan song?
We always sing it,
yeah? The song spread, didn't it?
Spread, like.
And what did it give people?
Hope.
And it was translated in many languages. People in France sing it, in Argentina, in Lithuania, in Russia, in Poland. It's such a famous song.
And but you were one of the first people to hear it.
Yeah, I was one of them. I was privileged.
That's pretty amazing. So Hirsch Glik had it in his head and then finally wrote it down. And then Philip was one of the first people to hear that song. Well, as a poem. And then they actually found music that is actually a Russian song.
Yeah.
And they matched it because it was a march. What inspired Hirschke to write the song?
He was a poet. So naturally, a poet wants to write. Like a musician wants to play music, a dancer wants to dance. That was part of his personality. But there was something else. We're living in the ghetto, where we never knew how long we'll survive, if we will survive at all. So this song gave us the hope, the strength to fight against Germans, the strength to live. Because people not only need the strength, you have to eat to be strong, but you need spiritual support. What does it mean, spiritual?
Inside, like you need hope in your heart.
Yeah, it's something in your heart which helps you.
I was told that he was inspired by the events of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising.
Basically, people think so. I personally don't think he never said it. He was rather inspired by the deeds of this girl.
And by the partisans.
Yeah, by the partisans. Her name was Kempler.
Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure.
Shane and Danke.
Zog nit keynmol letzten Weg. Die Wärter Kaczerginski. Das ist ein Partisanermarsch, ausgeführt von Betty Segal, akkompaniert Kiva Deiches, Amatone von der Jüdischen Münchener Historischer Kommission.
Wenn Himmeln bleien verstellen bleue Dinge, weil kommen wird noch unser Reus gebinkte Schau. Uns wird abbeugt und unser Trott mir seinen Do. Nos hat der Volk zwischen Fahlen die gewinnt. Das Lied gesungen mit ner Gannes in die Hand. Nos hat der Volk zwischen Fahlen die gewinnt. Das Lied gesungen mit ner Gannes in die Hände.
Never say you are going your last way.
though lead filled skies above blot out the blue of day. The hour for which we long will certainly appear. The earth shall bend beneath our tread, that we are here. Mir Zion Dor.